I'm Ros Atkins. Welcome back to Global Live from here in London and also from the G20 in St. Petersburg, where John Sopel is. We'll speak to him a little more a bit later on in the programme. Now, the battle for the right to host the 2020 Summer Olympics is entering the final straight. 2 days to go before the International Olympic Committee chooses between Madrid, Istanbul and Tokyo. Now, in a moment, we're going to be talking to people from all three cities. But first of all week, we've been profiling how their bids are shaping up today. Today is the turn of Istanbul. Here's the BBC's Güne Yıldız.
Istanbul, one of the most vibrant cities of the world, is gearing up for its 2020 Olympic bid with the slogan, "Step beyond sport to make history." It's clear in the city's promotional video that they are going all out to secure the games. A recent poll found that over 80% of the city's citizens support the bid. But reactions on the street are mixed.
I think it's a must for Turkey's reputation and development. Istanbul deserves this, and I think Istanbul has many advantages with regards to other cities.
This will be a good step for Turkey's reputation, but in my opinion, Istanbul might not be a suitable place considering its heavy traffic and high population.
In recent months, there were violent clashes between police and tens of thousands of protesters, which started over a redevelopment plan for an inner-city park. There are also concerns over the potential security fallout from the ongoing conflict in neighboring Syria. Some think that this has turned Istanbul into a riskier bet to host the games. But government officials believe these issues won't damage their chances.
Turkey has many stories of victory in tough conditions. Of course, we would prefer that Gezi Park protests hadn't taken place during this period. However, they did. But I don't think that we should be concerned or discouraged because of what happened.
Tokyo and Madrid are also in the running to host the games. But if Istanbul were to win, Turkey would make history and be the first nation with a majority Muslim population to stage the world's biggest multi-sports event. Güne Yıldız, BBC News.
So that's how it's shaping up for Istanbul. Now, joining us live from the Bullring in Madrid, we have Rodrigo Garza, a Spanish Olympian, also a gentleman who's involved in the campaign for 2020. Here in the studio, we've got Turkish analyst and researcher Ziya Moral. Nice to see you, Ziya. And also Charles Nishikawa, who's a Japanese businessman based in London. Now, Charles, let me start with you. Explain to our sceptical viewers why Tokyo maybe should win this.
Well, I think we are confident that Tokyo can actually bring the best Olympic. And we learned a lot of things from London. And a lot of people said that, you know, Tokyo is really safe in terms of the infrastructure, modern technology, but also more than that, maybe culture side, kind of interesting mix of the traditional and also new modern city culture there, cool Japan, food. We have plenty of sushi, for instance.
You've got very successful Olympians as well. You did very well in London, didn't you?
Exactly.
So that might be a factor. Okay,
yes,
Rodrigo, let's bring you in. For viewers who are not sure if Madrid is a good idea, tell them why your city deserves to win.
Well, I think everyone knows that Madrid has been following this for the last 10 years, and our project is real, no? It's not a promise. You can see it, and we can say that we are ready for it. And also, apart from this, everyone knows about the passion for sports here in Spain, how we follow sports, how it's in our culture. And I think after all the success we have had in the last 10 years, I think it's time for Madrid. We really deserve it.
Okay, thank you very much. And in fact, yesterday we saw a report from the BBC's Tom Burridge, who was saying that 80% of these huge infrastructure projects in Spain are already finished. So they're a bit ahead of the game. But let's talk about Istanbul. Why do you think it deserves the nod?
I think it deserves it really strongly for three major reasons we can give. One is symbolically. Istanbul is a city that has been developed for thousands of years. It encompasses the Olympic spirit by virtue of the fact that it's literally set on two continents. Culturally, Turks are known for their hospitality. In fact, more than 30 million tourists visit Turkey every year, and Turks love their sports. But practically too, Turkish economy is robust, Turkish state is fully behind this vision, and Turkish architectural firms, Turkish infrastructure is ready to deliver on what is needed for Olympics.
All right, well, all three of you make the case. Let's look at some of the doubts that people have, starting with Istanbul. They've seen the huge protests. There's some concern about security in Istanbul. Also, Turkey's very keen to get involved in any military intervention in Syria. That may make it a divisive presence on the world stage. What would you say to those concerns?
Perhaps. If you look at the protest this summer, that was definitely a challenge. It showed the direction Turkey has to go in improving in human rights record. But I think the Olympics process will actually enable that. Even after those protests, even at the height of the Syria crisis, the number of tourists visiting Turkey are actually increasing. They're not decreasing. Turkey is an extremely safe country to travel, even for individuals on their own. So I do not see a major security threat or any threat for anybody who is Turkey at any time, let alone in the time of the Olympics, which is quite some time.
All right, okay, and Rodrigo, let's turn to you. I think the first thing people would say to Madrid is, hold on, haven't you got such big problems with your economy? Spending billions of dollars on the Olympics is not what you need.
Well, it's what we have been trying to explain this for the last 2 years. We just need the budget we need is 1.5 billion, so the return on investment is secure. We benefit from all the things we have done in the last 10 years. You mentioned before 80% of the venues are already constructed, are already finished. So, and this for the Olympic Games, to host Olympic and Paralympic Games, this is the most expensive part, no, of the budget. So the return on investment, as I said before, is really, really secure.
Okay, and one point, Charles, that you must look at, and the timing is not great. I was just reading the news half an hour ago, and there's still a lot of attention on Fukushima. I know that that actually hasn't affected life in Tokyo, but in the minds of the people voting, that might be a problem for you.
Well, actually, if you take a look at the position of Fukushima, it's nearly 300 kilometers away from Tokyo. And then, as you said, that the actual, like, a normal life down in Tokyo is... It's as usual as possible. And the well, obviously it's a serious issue that. However, the government is working really hard to actually to solve the problem. And first of all, as the Japanese, I trust the people. They're working tirelessly to solve this problem. I trust them.
And what about your economy? The Japanese economy's had 20 years of problems. Do you
really
need the cost of the Olympics?
That's exactly what we need, that, because
we
have
the Olympics will help. Spending billions of dollars is going to sort it out.
Exactly. But also we have huge, the multinational corporations there. All those people back up our cause, particularly this Tokyo 2020. And I hope everything's going to be really fine.
Now, I must ask all of you, and I'm going to start with Rodrigo, because I know what his answer will be. Every city wants to offer iconic venues, and you're at one, aren't you? I've seen the bullfighting at this famous Las Ventas bullring, but the bulls are not involved in the Olympics. It's basketball, right?
Yeah, it's basketball. It's what I was telling before, no? We are trying to benefit from all the big buildings, all the monuments we have in Madrid already done, so we don't need to build new venues, no? It's, I think it's a smart movement from the last candidature. Different from the last ones, it's one step forward that we made. And I think IOC members recognize this good idea.
All right, so we've got basketball at the bullring. Of course, London had beach volleyball at Horse Guards parades. What will Tokyo give us that will surprise us?
Well, I think it's a whole total package there. We have very concise, very close, at the proximity in terms of the old and new venue, and also heritage venues there. The iconic 1964, the first Tokyo Olympic Stadium is going to be transformed into really nice form in the modern form, but also it has the heritage legacy of the first Olympic we hosted.
Istanbul?
It is one of the most beautiful cities on earth you can visit. It's truly dazzling. It's got all of the facilities that are ready. It gives so much more to people who visit Istanbul beyond sports. They will be able to enjoy a lot of cultural as well as beautiful products in the town too. And Turkey is a gateway for Africa, Middle East and Asia and Europe. A lot of people will be able to arrive Istanbul easily and cheaply.
Now, one last issue. The Olympics and politics go hand in hand, not just the sports politics, but normally at this stage in the last few days, your leaders get involved. Do you think that they have the potential to swing it? Tony Blair famously spent 3 days knocking on people's doors saying, give London the chance. Do you think with all the other distractions, your leaders are going to be able to make time for this?
I think so. This time, actually, Prime Minister Abe, he cut off his schedule in the G20. In St. Petersburg, and he will fly to Buenos Aires to do the final push.
That is serious commitment.
The same commitment comes from the Turkish government too. Turkish Prime Minister has written to all of the committee members. Mm. All of the Turkish state is actively involved in promoting Turkey. I don't see we see any lack of zeal or excitement on part of Turkey, or we ever did.
Okay, and Prime Minister Rajoy, Will he be going to Argentina to make the case, Rodrigo?
Yeah, as well as Rajoy is going there, and also our Prince Felipe, which is an Olympic athlete himself, is the head of the presentation. No, he will be leading the presentation. So what else can I say? We have a good team there.
I like it. You're sending the politicians and royalty. Can you two do that?
Maybe. Sure, or if you want some pop stars as well, we could.
And while there's a lot of hope, isn't there, ahead of these kind of votes? But you know, the Olympics is a complicated business, and there are a lot of deals done behind closed doors, a lot of money involved. Do you remain happy for your country to sit down with the IOC and create something? You still trust the Olympics as an organization?
Well, we've been the good member of the Olympic family for such a long time, and the contribution the Japanese actually made, that was tremendous. We still believe that, and it will be.
Well, Saturday's the day. Rodrigo, Zia, Charles, thank you very much. Best of luck to all three of you. I'm not going to take sides in this. Remember, you'll get news of who has won the right to host the 2020 Olympics here on BBC News just as soon as we get it. Now, do stay.